What was it, Major?
Well, I will come to the dream later. I do not think, comrades, that I shall be with you for many months longer. And before I die, I... Please, please, please. Before I die, I feel it my duty to pass on such wisdom as I have acquired. Comrades, what is the nature of this life of ours? Our lives are miserable, laborious, and short. We are born, given just so much food as will keep the breath in our bodies, and forced to work to the very last atom of our strength. The very instant that usefulness ends, well, we are slaughtered with hideous cruelty. No animal knows happiness or leisure, and no animal is free. But is that simply the order of nature? Is it because this land of ours is so poor? No. No, 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 no. 1,000 times no! This soil is capable of affording food in abundance. Why then? Why do we continue in this miserable condition? Oh, it is summed up in a single word. Man. Man is the only enemy we have.
Man!
The movement and the root cause for hunger and overwork. It is abolished forever.
Man is the only creature that consumes without producing.
Man does not give milk.
He does not lay eggs.
He is too weak to pull the plow.
Yes!
Yes!
Yet he is one of all the animals.
He
sets us to work. How many eggs have you laid this last year that hatched into chickens?
Too few.
Quite right. Most of your eggs have gone to market to bring in money for Jones and his kind. And Clover. Clover, where are the foals that you bought?
Each was sold at a year old.
So, our miserable lives are not even allowed to reach their natural span. I was lucky. You young porkers, however, each one of you will scream your lives out at the block within a year. To that horror, you must all come. Cows, pigs, hens, sheep, everyone. Even the horses and the dogs, they have no better fate. You boxer.
Yes, Major.
The very day that those great muscles of yours, they lose their strength, Jones will send you to the knacker, who will cut your throat and boil you down for fox house.
Unfair!
And as for the dogs, oh, when you grow old, oh, when you grow toothless, Jones will tie a brick around your neck and drown you in the nearest pond!
No!
What can we do?
Say that again!
What can we do?
What can we do? Oh, is it not clear? Get rid of man! And the produce of our labor, well, it would be our own!
We would be rich!
And free!
Yes! That is my message to you, comrades! Rebellion!
Rebellion!
Sooner or later, justice will be done. Until that day comes, we must pass on this message to future generations until we are victorious.
Our resolution must never falter.
No argument must lead us astray.
Yes, and never listen when they tell you that man and animal, they have a common interest. All men are enemies.
All men are enemies.
All animals are comrades.
All animals are comrades!
And now, comrades, here's a point that must be settled. The wild creatures, such as the rats and the rabbits, are they our friends or are they our enemies? Let us put it to a vote.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
All in favor of rats and rabbits.
The two legs! Enemy!
Enemy!
All that walks upon four legs or has wings. Oh, well, that is a friend.
Friend!
And remember, comrades, when fighting man, we must never come to resemble him. Even when you are competent, do not adopt his vices. No animal must ever live in a house, or sleep in a bed, or wear clothes, or drink alcohol, or touch money, or engage in trade. All the habits of man, evil.
Evil!
And above it all,
above it all, no animal must ever tyrannize upon his own kind. Weak or strong, clever or simple, we are all brothers. No animal may ever kill another animal.
No animal must ever kill any other animal.
All animals are equal.
All animals are equal.
Oh, now, comrades, now I shall come to my dream. It was of the earth as it will be when man is vanished. It reminded me of a song my mother used to sing to me, which had long since passed from my mind. Last night, however, it came back to me. It's called Beasts of England.
Bow, 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 bow.